Hi everyone, welcome to Crypto Market, the educational channel about cryptocurrencies. In this video, I bring you a tutorial of the popular Exodus wallet. This wallet is compatible with more than 50 networks, and we can store more than 300 cryptocurrencies. This wallet can be installed on the desktop, on the mobile device, and you can add it to your browser. And additionally, if you have a Trezor wallet, you can link it to manage your funds with greater security. In this video, we are going to look at the desktop version, how it is used, and how it is linked to the Trezor wallet. The desktop version is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. When you install the application, you can do two things. The first is to use the wallet that is automatically created, and the second is that you can import a wallet that you already have created. This is important. Unlike other wallets, Exodus uses 12 seed words. If you're going to use the new wallet, the first thing you should do is go to this settings section and select backup. Here you will create a password for the wallet. This password is not part of the seed words, and it is not an additional parse phrase either. This is a password to protect the wallet in case someone else uses your computer. You confirm it. And on the next screen, the 12 seed words appear. The application for security only shows you the word when you place the cursor over it. Always remember to save these words in the same order that they appear here and offline. Do not take photos or save them in the cloud. Always save them offline. And finally, the wallet asks you to place a word at random. Here it asks me to select the word number 11. And if we select it correctly, the backup is completed. If you want, you can change the password, and at any time you can view the 12 seed words again. Here at the top, you will find a wallet icon. This section is where you can send and receive cryptocurrencies. Here is the list of all available currencies. You can configure this list. You go to the end and select Add More. This section is very interesting because here you can not only add and remove coins, you can also check which coins you can store using Trezor Wallet. You can search by placing the name directly here, and you can also filter according to the network you are looking for. For example, if you write USDD and select this arrow, all the available networks appear. Here you find the most popular networks. You simply add the ones you like the most and eliminate the ones you don't want to use. In this column, you can see if that coin is supported by the Trezor wallet. I recommend you always display the menu so you can verify exactly which currency is supported by the Trezor wallet and which is not. Again, in the wallet section, you can now select each currency. Here you find the balance, the buttons to send and receive, and on the right side is the option to make swaps. If you want, here you can view the chart of each coin. This chart is very basic. It is not for technical analysis or anything complex. Basically, what it shows you is an overview of the price. If, for example, you select USDD, the available networks appear here. If you want to receive, you must look closely at the network you are going to use and copy the address. I am going to send a few dollars from the Matic wallet. Here you paste the address, enter the amount, choose the commission, and that's it. Here you can see that the dollars already appear. If you go to the portfolio icon, the coins that you add to the wallet will appear here. In this icon, you can make swaps. You choose the currency you want to change, and here below you select the currency you want to receive. Here, swaps cannot be made for small amounts. You also have the option to buy directly with a credit card. You can choose the currency of your country and select the currency you want to buy. These two options, the swap option and the card purchase option, should be used as a last alternative because they can generate high commissions. The best thing to do would be to buy directly on the exchanges and store them here in the wallet. In this plus sign, you can install some additional applications. This first one is for invest in Exodus. Exodus has shares with the exit symbol and is regulated by the SEC. Here you can register and apply to buy the shares. In the second, you can get rewards. Here the available coins appear and the APY appears. For example, they are offering a 7% annual profit for Solana. Here you can calculate the earnings by placing in this part the amount of Solana you want to use. And below you select how many months you want to block the cryptocurrency, and here it shows you approximate earnings. These applications can be uninstalled at any time. If you have NFTs, you can store them by installing this application. Currently, the wallet receives NFTs in the Algorand, Ethereum, and Solana networks. And here in the last one, you find the installer of the browser wallet. In this icon, you can make some additional settings. You can configure a time for the application to be blocked in case you leave the computer on. If you activate the lock by time, a lock is enabled up here, and if you don't use the application in 5 minutes, it is automatically locked, or you can also lock it yourself at any time by moving the lock. If it is blocked, you enter the password and you can continue using the application without problem. This devices tab is very important because here is where the process with the Trezor wallet begins. If suddenly you don't know these wallets, there are currently two models, the Trezor Model T and the Trezor Model 1. Both are very safe and very good. The Model T has a touch screen and additionally receives more coins than the Model 1. The best thing you should do is buy a Trezor to keep your funds safe. In the description of the video, you will find the direct link to purchase the Trezor wallet that you like the most. In order to link the Trezor with the Exodus wallet, the first thing you must do is install this bridge. The application takes you to the official Trezor page. You choose the operating system, download it, and install it. Here, there is no icon or button to link the Trezor. Simply what you do is connect it to the computer and Exodus automatically recognizes it. Enter your Trezor PIN. Here it asks you if you want to use the standard wallet or if you want to enter the parse phrase to enter the hidden wallet. In the videos, I always use the standard one, so I just click continue. Here you confirm that if you want to connect the two wallets. And that's it. You can go to the portfolio section. Here you can see that the funds are completely separated. If you select the Trezor portfolio and go to the wallet, see that in each coin, this icon indicates that you are in the Trezor wallet. You can choose the coins from here, or you can also go to the portfolio section, and at the bottom you select the currency. In this icon, you can transfer funds from one portfolio to another. Here enter the amount. These types of transfers are not like exchanges that are free. Here you are moving funds within each blockchain, so here you do have to pay commissions for transfer. In these transfers between portfolios, you don't have to specify the address, Exodus shows it automatically. Here it appears. If you want to receive, copy the address, paste it in the other wallet and send. In the Exodus, the notification that the Zcash are entering already appears. And that's it, here the Zcash appear. So, these Zcash are inside the Trezor wallet. I always recommend you first select the portfolio and then select the wallet. Now to send, here you paste the destination address. Choose the amount. Here the transaction date appears again to verify. Select Send. And now you confirm the transaction from the Trezor device, and that's it. It already appears that the funds are being sent. Now in the other wallet, it already appears that the Zcash was received. See how easy it is to use. Now I am going to show you how to send USDD. You select the portfolio, you go to the wallet, and here you choose the USDD. I have them in the Polygon network. Here, what you must keep in mind is that you must have a balance of the cryptocurrency with which the commissions of each network are paid. Remember that Zcash is a cryptocurrency, and the commissions are paid with the same Zcash. But if you move tokens like USDD, you need to have some of the network's own cryptocurrency. In this case, I need to have some Matic, which is the own currency by Polygon. You paste the address. Place the amount. Verify the information and send. In the other wallet, the completed transaction already appears. This is the Trezor wallet suite. And see that after receiving and sending this cash from the Exodus wallet, all the history is recorded here. Here the deposit appears, and it also appears when I send all the Zcash. As you can see, this wallet is very easy to use and complements perfectly with the Trezor wallet. Remember that when installing wallets on your PC, you must be very careful with security, with the pages you visit, with the links, with the downloads, and with the programs you install. You must be very careful and not compromise your assets. Well, that's all for this video. I tried to make the video very clear. Remember that this video is for educational purposes only and does not represent any investment advice. Thanks so much for the support, and don't forget subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next videos.